Today we're going to walk through pre-harvest management, pre-harvest expectations, and a little bit of a bonus to help us manage for a year from now. Okay, my name is Carl Schulting with Winfield United. I'm going to walk you through some of the key steps that I like to go through when I walk into a field or a plot to understand which field should I harvest first. What are my yield expectations on this farm? And then lastly, what are some things that I can learn to help me manage for next year, whether it's disease tolerance, whether it's trait usage, all those different factors. So come along with me and we'll take a look at some of these factors I like to look at right before harvest season. One thing that's an easy observation is just nutrient deficiency. As you can see here, I've got some different hybrids, but one thing sticks out. If we look at this hybrid right here, we can definitely tell we've got some challenges coming on. Oftentimes when I see this light color, this discoloration, it usually leads to a nutrient deficiency such as nitrogen. Now the other thing that comes along with that, could we have stalk issues, as in we cannibalize the stalk? So we want to do what we call a pinch test. Let's come on in here and take a look. Okay, I look right here. I'm just going to go down the line and I'm going to pinch these stalks. Okay, that one's fine. Oh, look at that right there. Okay, an issue. Okay, look at this. I'm not very strong, but we got an issue there. Here's another issue. I'm able to pinch right there and twist. Okay, we've got some breakage. Now here's good, here's good, here's good. Here's one right here where we got some issues, okay? Now, if I take a look, it might not just be nutrient deficiency, but just look right in there. We've got stalk rots, okay? So it's very important that we walk through these fields where we're seeing discoloration as this plant is starting to senesce and die off. We wanna do the pinch test. Now, if you're lazy, you can always do this, okay? You can do a quick kick test. Look what happens. We broke right off there, okay? But pick a number of plants. Could be 10, could be 20, could be once or twice or five times within the field. Take a hard look at what our stalks look like, because that's going to ultimately tell us how soon we need to harvest that field. Is it going to go down quickly or is it going to stay standing? This pinch test or kick test, whichever you prefer, is really going to tell us a big story in terms of nutrient deficiency, standability, and stalk rots. Now I'm in the field trying to figure out what's this puppy gonna yield like, okay? For me personally, it's all about consistency. I want a husk back, a set of ears here that just is consistent. Every single ear, not so much I need a lot of density, but I just want a lot of consistency. And here's a hybrid here, just every single ear looks good, okay? I don't get a bunch of little dinks or a bunch of little doinks. Everything just looks good, okay? So I can tell whether I got 26,000 plants out here in this hybrid, whether I've got 30, 36, this is gonna be very high yielding relative to its population because everything looks good, everything is consistent, okay? This to me is a really important factor of knowing whether a field is gonna yield well or not. It tells me it emerged well, it tells me that it flowered consistently. And then the other thing I like to do while I'm in here is take a look at different foliar diseases. Do we see any? Here, right here, we haven't seen this pop up much in the last couple years, especially in the West. Goss's wilt, okay? Take notes of anything that you're seeing inside that canopy. Here's Goss's wilt. Some other plots I've walked, I've seen southern rust. Now, I'm also gonna look down low for some Physoderma stalk rot, okay? I don't see any in here. The Physoderma is a disease, a stalk rot that we've got really a lot of trending volume out there in the fields today because of some of the genetics. They're just not very resistant to it. So Physoderma, Goss's, southern rust, gray leaf spot, all those things you want to look for while you're here in the canopy. But as I mentioned earlier, on the ears, consistency is key. I haven't even counted length, I haven't counted rows around. I know just by husking back 10 in a row whether or not I've got a good picture for yield opportunity or a poor picture for yield opportunity. That means a lot to me.